I don't have any family history of cancer, and I would consider myself a healthy person. I exercise regularly, I don't smoke. And so when I was diagnosed with lung cancer, it came as a shock for me and my family. My name is Phuong Ho. I am 48 years old. My family and I immigrated from Vietnam when I was in high school, and I've been living in the Bay Area ever since. I am an emergency physician, and I have been working at Kaiser Permanente Medical Center in Fremont and San Leandro for the last 17 years. I love just to spend time with my family, my husband, my children, my mom. We do a lot of home cooking. I was 45 years old when I was first diagnosed with lung cancer. I started to have symptoms of mild chronic cough and chest tightness. I still remember the day when my physician called and told me about my diagnosis. I had stage 1A. And as a physician, I didn't even realize the prevalence of Asian female non-smoker having a higher incidence of developing lung cancer. And so I would encourage primary care physician and other physician out there to pay a little bit more attention to this particular population who has any kind of chronic symptoms, and to consider lung cancer as a differential diagnosis and to search further. We all had a very difficult time. I had a very difficult time accepting the diagnosis. I was able to share with my husband, but I had a difficult time sharing or explaining to my young children. It was difficult. So after I was diagnosed with lung cancer, I met with my pulmonologist and my oncologist, and I underwent a series of CT scan and PET scan just to make sure there's no metastasis or the spread of cancer anywhere else in the body. I was found to just have localized lung cancer of my right upper lobe. And after the consultation with the thoracic surgeon, we made the decision to have the whole right upper lobe removal. Everything turned out well, and surgery considered to be the definitive treatment for my cancer at that point. I would consider myself very lucky to receive the cancer screening and testing early. And I was diagnosed early to find that there's no spread of the cancer, and to get the surgery also done very quickly after that. I am still working on improving my health with regular exercise, and I'm thankful. I'm thankful to have the health that I have now. After my diagnosis of lung cancer, I realized that there is a rise in the incidence of Asian female non-smoker having lung cancer. Through my experience, I am an advocate for my Asian communities. I participate in the FAN study developed by the UCSF to study on the indications that could have raised the risk of lung cancer in this population. As for lawmaker and policymakers, I would suggest to continue funding and support for researcher to develop cancer marker for early detection of any kind of cancer, and also a little bit more focus on the ethnic minorities and underserved population, because they are the one that do not have regular medical care or seek medical attention. Increase in focus of education, in health education, and bring that to the communities, and also with the focus to increasing access to healthcare to those communities would be greatly helpful.